The likelihood of finding a snail today is pretty low, to be honest. You'd have a better chance of seeing them if you were here at night time. It's likely that they're here in extremely low abundance, so the chances of actually stumbling across one, especially on a trek, would be very low.
Horizons Regional Council is asking the public to keep an eye out for giant snails, which have recently been sighted at Tōtara Reserve Regional Park.
We don't have records of them being here previously, so it's why we're interested to know if anyone has any information about how they got here. And they are really, really susceptible to predators, so it's really cool that we know they're here.
Snails usually protect themselves really, really well during the daytime, so really dense leaf litter and vegetation that kind of hangs down to the ground, anywhere they can really burrow themselves right into is where you'd most likely find the snail.
The snail in question, Poeliphanta marcanti, and they're not your typical garden snail. It is said these carnivorous beasts can gobble earthworms like spaghetti, and apparently they don't mind taking a dip in the ice-cold Pohangina River.
Before we knew about this snail species being here in this reserve, probably the closest known location we had for them was at the top of the Pohangina River catchment.
So we think it's probably equally likely that they made their way here being washed down the Pohangina River, or that someone, but it may have been a bit of human intervention, and someone may have dropped them off here, either thinking they had an empty shell or dropped off some live snails.
Poeliphanta marcanti are giants of the snail world, measuring up to 9 centimetres across, but that doesn't make them any easier to spot. Today's snail hunt was unsuccessful, but Liz and Ruby brought something they'd prepared earlier.
These shells here were two of the original shells that were collected in this reserve. Well, this particular species of snail is what we would call a medium-sized Poeliphanta snail. They're not as big as they can get, but they're not the smallest either. This species can grow up to about 5 centimetres wide. The one Ruby's holding is a pretty good example of about as big as they can get.
Originally, a couple of shells were spotted in 2017 by contractors, and since then we've had reports of more shells found and a live snail, and we were able to get the snails identified by Dr. Kath Walker, who is our go-to for snail expertise. So she was able to identify the snails and the shells that we found as Poeliphanta marcanti.
There's two kind of main things that threaten Poeliphanta snails generally, one being predation by introduced mammals, and the other one being habitat modification and deterioration through fire and grazing, and also browsing by introduced ungulates like deer and pigs. So the fact that they are here could reflect the fact that, you know, predator control is being done, and perhaps deer population is low and the habitat isn't a generally good quality.
Regional Response Officer Ray Palmer believes pest control will help the native species live their best lives.
We try and to reduce the rat numbers in the reserve and to help the birds in their life, and the snails, of course. Yeah. And the main predators being hedgehogs, rats and stoats. Also the occasional cat and ferret. We also use rabbit bait and also a terracotta scented lure. So Tōtara Reserve is one of the last remnants of native bush for the Manawatū area. We have 600 or more bait stations currently in the reserve, and we've got 150 traps which we service once a month. It's a very intensive program, and we're hoping that we see some really good results.
What we're hoping is that if anyone, any members of the public within the reserve spot any of the snails, that they can let us know. They can send us photos and GPS coordinates. If anyone has any memories of releasing snails, or grandparents or parents releasing snails, that just informs our understanding of how they got here. This is not a place we'd found them before. This is not a place we have records of them before. So the more records we can get, the more we know.
Ben Carter, Local Focus.